this short video, I'm going to demonstrate some of the new workspace management features that are part of ADS 2019. From a design standpoint, I'm going to keep things pretty simple. The example I have here is just a workspace of a power amplifier chip on a board. At the lowest level, there is a chip that has a power transistor, then the chip gets bonded into a flange package, and the package is mounted onto a laminated board to do the matching and filtering. Even though the circuits and the packaging are fairly basic, the workspace can still get kind of complicated because several different technologies are being integrated together here to make this design. And each of those technologies has its own library containing things like physical designs and circuit models. All of those elements need to work together to get a successful simulation. Here's a diagram of the libraries and cells inside of the workspace. There are separate libraries for the board, the package, the chip, and the surface mount components, which are going on the board. The top simulation is called Test Bench, which is invoked out of the board library. This cell is kind of like the master that combines all of the lower level designs together to actually simulate the whole product. Now, further down the chain, the chip library references a design kit, which contains parts of the IC process technology, things like transistor models, and also the surface mount filter in the components library. At the output references an external measured data file to model the passive response. And then there are a whole bunch of interdependencies between the libraries and cells throughout the workspace that are necessary for the simulation to work. So for example, the test bench uses the top board design, the board design uses the package design and the surface mount components, the package uses the chip, and that has multiple levels of hierarchy itself. And if any link breaks, say the data file for the filter is missing, then the top level simulation doesn't work. So what I'll show you now is a set of features in ADS 2019 that enables users to explore these interdependencies and to troubleshoot problems interactively before running a simulation. I think most ADS users will find this tremendously helpful to understand these complex workspaces. So here's the workspace in the main window showing the different libraries. This is the board library, and inside of it is the test bench simulation, which is the top cell in the entire workspace. From the test bench, I can push into the schematic for the board, and this has the flange packaged amplifier and also some surface mount components. So let's explore this in more detail. From the main window, I'll go to View, References, and that brings up a docking window at the bottom, and then I can just drag that test bench cell down here to see what subdesigns it uses. In this case, it uses the board top cell, and if I drag that down, you can now see that board top uses SMD components and the package top cell. And I can right-click and find that in the library view. And I can just continue to explore this chain of dependency by dragging and dropping. Okay, so the references traverse downward, but let's say you're looking at the chain starting not from the master cell, but somewhere in the middle, like with the package. References show what cells the design uses, yes, but what about the other way? What designs use this package cell? To see that, I'll invoke the dependence window by selecting View Dependence, and then I will drag the package top cell down here, and now it becomes clear that the board design uses the package design. It's just going the other direction on the tree, so references is a way of kind of looking down into the hierarchy, and dependence is a way of looking up into the hierarchy. So the two views we've got so far are limited to a single level. You can only see, for example, that the board uses the package, or the package is used by the board, and you'd have to drag more cells in to see the next level of hierarchy, but sometimes you want to see the entire chain of hierarchy all at once, and to do that, I'll use View Usage Hierarchy. So now if I drag the top test bench here, it's possible to walk down from the board to the package to the chip and to the design kit all in one step. All of this is traced. Now these tools I've shown so far are like a magnifying glass for sections of your workspace, which is great, but if you're looking too closely at a specific area, you might miss a problem somewhere else. So there's also utility that helps with that. It lets you check out the whole workspace at once and identify problems. Just go to Tools, Check Design. And when I run it on this example workspace, it turns out I find a problem. The data for the bandpass filter component is missing, and that's going to break the simulation. The problem's automatically flagged in the dependence window. It's saying here that this data file, which is used by the bandpass filter component, is missing. And I can just right-click and update the path. In this case, it looks like the file got renamed. So I'll repoint the path and run check design again, and now there are no issues. So this check workspace tool is super useful for catching issues up front. Finally, let's talk about sharing workspaces. Now to do that in ADS, typically you make an archive. But with big, complex workspaces, there can be some problems with that. Sometimes there's a lot of unnecessary or outdated files, and those can bloat the archive. Other times, you only want to share a section of the workspace, but you also want to include all of the other hierarchy that's necessary for that simulation to run. So let's start with removing old files. There's a new feature in ADS 2019 called Cleanup Workspace. This checks for temporary files or files that result from incomplete executions and files also that could be easily generated again. And the utility gives the user the option to remove these for the sake of reducing the size and complexity of the workspace. So in this example, you can see it's flagged a backup data display file for a design that's no longer in the workspace. And it's no problem for me to delete that. Now, the size savings is pretty minimal here, but in some cases, you can really save a ton of space before you archive by using this cleanup utility. Also, when you go to archive your workspace, it's now possible in ADS 2019 to automatically add in all of the lower-level hierarchy to the archive that's needed to simulate a top cell. So this means, for example, I can check the top test bench only, and then I can automatically add in all the necessary subcells and substrates which are needed to simulate this. So it would add the package, the chip, the components, all of that stuff with one button click. The archive function also will seek out and preserve external workspace files, like in this case, the S2P file for the filter. That was outside of the workspace, and it'll now add this file to the data directory of the archive and update all the paths in the archive workspace to point there. So it's much more robust as far as being able to capture and simulate self-contained sections of the workspace. All right, that wraps up the demo. In closing, there are a number of new workspace management features in ADS 2019. Today I showed you the hierarchy exploration and troubleshooting tools. I showed you the workspace check and cleanup utilities and the improved archiving. Now, one thing that I didn't get a chance to show here is that there are also performance improvements in ADS 2019 generally around cell operations like rename, delete, and copy. It's now much faster at managing the checks needed to perform these operations. So download ADS 2019 and try these things out with your own workspace. I think you'll find it useful. Thanks for watching.